Hello, everyone. Hope you're doing well. Couple announcements before we dive into our passage. First, Slack. If you are not on Slack, and remember, Slack is social media where we can share ideas for podcasts, post a prayer request, discuss something that we heard in the sermon, share music ideas, discipleship ideas, anything along those lines. But if you're interested in that and you're not a part of that, find Conrad Goboff and ask him to get you signed up, and he will do that. Second, if you're not receiving the newsletter, Rick and I can help you with that. Remember, our newsletter just outlines events, outlines different resources we have. You can access the sermon. These videos are all our newsletter, just everything that we want to get out to you. But if you're not signed up for that, please see Rick or myself. And then third, on July 3rd, the Goboffs are having a movie night at their house. And this is going to be a great night for fellowship. Please feel free to invite family, friends. We hope you come and be a part of that. It'll be a great time to meet other people in the church and just connect a little bit more as we commit to one another. Okay, our passage. We had 3 points of emphasis, so let's dive in and look at the first one. We looked at Mark chapter 5, 21 to 43. And our first point was this, that Jesus became unclean so we could be clean. And I'm reminded of Paul's letter to the Corinthians, 2 Corinthians 5, verse 21, where we read this. God made him, Jesus, who had no sin, to become my sin, to become your sin, so that we might become the righteousness of God. And what a picture we get of that here in two ways. The lady who was unclean, who's had the bleeding problem for years, she touches Jesus and she is made clean. And then Jesus goes to the little girl that's dead. She's unclean. He takes her by the hand. He says, Talitha kume, in the gentlest, tenderest voice, little girl, get up. And she is made clean. And remember, we want to be a church that walks daily in the gospel. A Christ-centered church that walks daily in the gospel. And so we have to constantly speak the gospel to ourselves. And this passage really reminds us of what the gospel means to us. So continue to speak the gospel to yourself. Second, the Lord responds to the smallest act of genuine faith in him. So what does this look like for us? As we sit under the promises of God, as we learn about his character, as we take in who he is, the Lord would say to us, are you walking by faith in those promises? Are you walking by faith in the fact that I will never leave you nor forsake you? Are you walking by faith in the fact that I'm not limited by time, that I'm sovereign, my character? And I think the Lord would just ask us that question. And then along those lines, our last point, he is worthy of our trust. So do we believe when our circumstances fail us? Do we believe that when the rubber meets the road, that we can trust God, that he knows what's best, that he cares for us, that he loves us, that he has the eternal on his mind, meaning that he wants us to grow in our relationship with him. He wants others to grow in their relationship with him. He wants those that are lost in our circles to come to life in him. That he has the kingdom in mind. And so do we believe that in those situations? And here's how I want to challenge you. As we did in our small group last night together, I want to encourage you to write down how God has been faithful to you in the last year. How have you seen his hand at work? Where have you seen God continue to provide for you? Where have you seen yourself grow spiritually? Where has he revealed more of himself to you? Take 10 minutes and do that. And I think you'll find that that really blesses you and creates worship in you. So those are our 3 points. I hope that this video you find helpful. It's been beneficial just to once again hide the word of God in our hearts and see that we're applying the scriptures. I pray that you're making touches. I pray that you see yourself on mission this week. And we look forward to seeing you on Sunday. And we love you.